Hello my crafty friends, welcome to our channel. I am Anu, designer at Just My Craft, and today I'm back with another craft tutorial. But before we move forward, please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to never miss a video from us.
Today I will be sharing 4 easy textures and backgrounds with Transforme that you can use to create any home decor piece. So let's begin. First, have a look at the Transforme sheets from Dress My Craft. I am using the Vintage Tile Design Series 1-7 for this project. These are A4 size containing 6 designs per sheet. The designs are very beautiful and intricate, and these are actually designed to perfectly fit in any size of coasters. Now here I have 4 wooden coasters. These are going to be the base for Transforme for today's video. First, prep your base by sanding it a little. You need to make sure that it's clean and smooth before you start working on it. After that, I will be using white gesso as a primer. I believe by doing this you get much better results and painting makes easy this way. I do 2 coats of gesso, cover it entirely, and do the same for all the bases. For the first technique, I am taking a simple sponge I found lying around in my house, nothing fancy. Taking 2 shades of chalk paint, take 1 color on sponge and simply dab it like this and cover half of the base. Take the other color, do the same thing. Try to merge the 2 colors in the center and this will give you an ombre effect. Simple, right? Let it dry, do second coat if required. Here I am taking Vintage Tiles No. 1 Transforme, fussy cut the design, remove the plastic film on top and stick it on the base. Add water on top, press it with a sponge. Once the paper is wet completely, remove excess water using tissue and then simply slide down the backing. Let this dry for 2-3 minutes and then take cadence acrylic varnish. Apply it using a soft brush. Cover the entire surface, do at least 2 coats and it's done. Moving on to the second one, I am covering the base with cream shade of chalk paint using sponge. Cutting out the transforme from vintage tiles number 2 transforme. Placing it on the base to mask the area, taking a green shade of chalk paint and now simply splattering the paint using brush. Remove the transfer and let it dry. Now again, I am doing splatters, but this time with a darker shade of green. Let this dry too and it will look like this once done. Now simply remove the film from transforme and paste it on the base. Add water on top, press it with sponge. Remove the excess water with tissue and finally peel off the backing. Let it dry for few minutes and then seal it with 2 coats of varnish. For the next one, I am taking blue chalk paint and a stencil brush. I got this from a local shop. It has very rough bristles, excellent for texture. Simply take paint and dab it on the base. Add a little white in the center for contrast. Look at this texture, so nice. Fuzzy cut this image from Wintel Styles number 3 Transforme. Now you know the drill, peel, stick, wet and pull and finally varnish. For the last one, I am covering it with chalk paint first. Let it dry, then take patina shade chalk paint. And stencil brush. Take a little on top of the bristles and swipe left and right on the base. This is called dry brushing technique. Taking a brown shade of paint to distress the edges. I like how grungy and vintage it looks. Now fussy cut the design from Wintel Styles number 4 Transforme and repeat the steps. Have a look at all four together. How different and beautiful each one of these look. My favorite is the deer one with splatters. What's yours? Do tell me in the comments below.
So this was all from me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, do give it a thumbs up, leave some love in the comments and share this video with your friends. Also, all the supplies I've used in this video are linked in the description box below. You can check there. So now I'll take a leave and I'll be back again with another craft tutorial. Until then, see you on happy crafting.